Hello and welcome to this presentation on developing an object and event detection and recognition module for autonomous vehicle using simulator. I am Souvik Mandal. I am a computer science and engineering graduate from Indian Institute of Technology, Indore. This presentation is based on the research done by me and my colleague Nikhil under the supervision of Dr. Gaurinath Vanda.
Hello, I'm Tatwarthi Venkat Nikhil, a computer science and engineering graduate from Indian Institute of Technology, Indore. In this presentation, we are going to discuss how a simulator can help in autonomous driving research. We are also going to discuss the OADR module architecture and its performance indices. We wanted to get started with research in autonomous driving in the absence of true autonomous driving environment and to start a special interest group at IIT Indore. Simulators make it possible by providing virtual training and testing environments. IPG CarMaker Simulator helps design such complex scenarios. We wanted to develop an OADR module, which is an important perception unit for autonomous vehicles. This illustration shows the various research indexed at Google Scholar over the years. Object detection and vehicle motion prediction are two of the elemental research areas in autonomous driving. But object detection, which is also related to other fields, has much higher number of research papers compared to vehicle motion prediction. From this, we can see that the amount of research done in autonomous driving is significantly lower than the research done in other similar fields. This is mainly due to the previously mentioned reason, expensive infrastructure. This can be solved using simulators, but we can see that the simulation-based research in autonomous driving is even more minute. The image at the bottom right corner depicts a general autonomous vehicle architecture. Our OADR project lies in the environment perception unit. If we dive into the environment perception unit, we can see the architecture shown in the top image. From the left, we have different sensors, then various modules which process the data from these sensors, and finally to get results like vehicle position, dynamic object detection, and static object detection. In this research project, we have implemented localization module, dynamic and static object detection classification module, and event detection module. We have created more than 20 dynamic traffic scenarios with both static and dynamic entities like cars, pedestrians, traffic signs, and so on. The image at the top right corner shows the overview of one such scenario. In the image, different entities are highlighted using colored points. The three images in the bottom are instances captured by the camera sensor installed on the Ego vehicle during one such scenario. Object detection and classification module. We have used YOLOv3 version 3 or YOLOv3 algorithm in this module. YOLOv3 is extremely fast and reasonably accurate. It is fully convolutional, which helps to generalize the algorithm for cameras of different resolutions. It also has skip connections and upsampling, which helps in reducing the feature loss. We have used version 3 of this algorithm due to its 3-level detection and classification, which helps detect smaller objects with better accuracy. This is very useful as we require the detection of objects which are far from our Ego vehicle. To train this module, we have used Rovit Urban Object Detection dataset. It is a relatively smaller dataset, which is perfect for us as larger dataset requires higher performance power, in turn requiring GPU infrastructure. Traffic light classification subsystem. This subsystem falls under event detection module and it runs on the traffic lights annotated by the object detection and classification module. The image in the bottom displays different steps involved in this process. From the left, we have traffic lights annotated from the ODCM. Then we standardize the image and apply Gaussian filter to reduce the noise. After this, the image is sliced into three parts corresponding to three colors of a traffic light. Finally, the average brightness of the three regions is calculated, of which the region with highest brightness is selected. These are some of the statistics corresponding to the traffic light classification subsystem. Its average time of computation is 3.3 milliseconds. We have tested this subsystem against around 1200 images and we have achieved more than 99% accuracy. Now, my colleague Souvik will continue the discussion with traffic sign classification subsystem.
Thank you, Nikhil. Now, traffic sign classification subsystem. This subsystem falls under event detection module, and it uses the traffic signs annotated by the object detection and classification module. similarly like traffic light classification subsystem. In this case, we have used convolutional neural network based architecture to implement this subsystem. And we have trained this subsystem with German traffic sign dataset. The image at the bottom displays the architecture. First, we have traffic sign annotated by the object detection and classification module. Then we have few convolutional layer, max polling layer, and finally fully connected layer to identify the class of the traffic sign. These are few of the statistics corresponding to the traffic sign classification subsystem. So we have considered total 43 classes of traffic sign in this subsystem. We have trained the subsystem with around 34,000 images and tested it against around 10,000 images. The accuracy of the model is around 97% and average time of computation is 3.3 milliseconds. Next is lane detection subsystem. This subsystem falls under static object detection and classification module, and it estimates the lane coordinate as well as the radius of curvature of the lanes. It uses the primary camera sensor data. Now in this OIDR architecture, we have installed two camera sensors in our Ego vehicle. And the left camera sensor is our primary camera sensor. The image at the bottom displays the important steps involved in this process. So first we have video frame from the left camera sensor or our primary camera sensor. Then we apply noise reduction and edge detection steps to finally get the edge detected binary image. After that, we apply prospective transformation to get the top view of the lanes. Then we use histogram based method to estimate the lane coordinate. And once we have the lane coordinate, we fit it into 2D polynomial to finally get the radius of curvature. The image displayed here showcases the final output from this subsystem. Now depth estimation subsystem falls under localization module, and unlike previous subsystem, it uses both the right camera sensor data and the output from the object detection and classification module. It employs stereo depth estimation technique and uses the concept of triangulation. The image at the right summarizes the concept of triangulation, which is used by this subsystem to estimate the relative position of all the objects from the camera sensor. Now the accuracy of this subsystem is directly proportional to the area of image overlap of the camera sensors. And we can improve this accuracy by increasing the field of view of the camera sensor. Now this subsystem can estimate the relative position of all the objects which are at least 3 meters away from the camera sensors. Next is subsystem performance indices. This summarizes the performance of all the subsystems when integrated and tested with IPG CarMaker in real time. These results are based on object level and are not based on pixel level. Now in both cases of traffic sign and traffic light classification subsystem, the detection rate is around 95%. In case of lane detection subsystem, the detection rate is around 84%. In case of depth estimation subsystem, when the object is in ego lane, the detection rate is around 73%. And when the object is outside ego lane, the detection rate is around 70%. Finally, in case of object detection and classification subsystem, when the object is in ego lane, the detection rate is around 98%. And when the object is outside ego lane, the detection rate is around 72%. Now this is the complete OIDR system architecture integrated with IPG CarMaker. So first, here we have IPG Movie, which is a component of IPG CarMaker that can stream the camera sensor data to a pre-configured port. As previously mentioned, we have installed two camera sensors in our Ego vehicle. We have two frames, right frame and left frame. As left camera is our primary camera, we'll be forwarding the left frame to YOLO B3 module, our object detection and classification module, and lane detection subsystem. Now, once all the objects are classified and annotated in the object detection and classification module or YOLO V3 module, it will forward all the traffic sign to the traffic sign classification subsystem and all the traffic light to traffic light classification subsystem for further identification. Depth estimation subsystem will take the output from the YOLO V3 module and also the right frame. Now, once all the results are calculated, we'll do an augmentation, and augmented video can be viewed in real time. Now these are few observations we found while working on this project. While considering a simulator's camera sensor, we have to keep in mind that various anomaly can be introduced when the system is imported to a real Ego vehicle. This can change the system performance. but we can reduce this change by introducing a silent layer to the architecture, which can introduce similar noises. Also, the accuracy of the machine learning model is highly dependent on the diversity between the training data and testing data. Now, these potential limitations and their solutions are highly dependent on the simulator which is being used. For example, in case of IPG car maker, we don't need to introduce a silent layer because we can add those noise directly to the camera sensor configuration. So in conclusion, we can say that essential subsystem of autonomous vehicle can be efficiently validated using simulator in absence of a real working environment. Thus, users of simulator can help develop an economical and efficient state-of-the-art system for self-driving cars. So it is possible to research and develop into autonomous vehicle at university level without requiring expensive infrastructure. Please visit our GitHub repository for any further information. We would like to express our special thank of gratitude to IPG Automotive for their continued support during this project. Thank you.